Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Dorota Palicka, international nail artist and educator. And finally, I'm going to get rid of those old nails and create a new set of myself. I cannot really wait to have some wintery nails as well. You can have a wee preview of them in here. Yes, so this is going to be a kind of a little bit a different winter type of nails, but I really enjoy doing this set and I hope you really enjoy watching it as well. Let's start. Hi guys, so you can see this bling nail, and it's actually a shame to take them off, but they have been on for ages and I really desperately needing the infill. So I'm just going to clip those crystals off and then show you the rebalance and then those pink beautiful Christmas set. But also before I do that, I want to guys show you something, because these sets have been kind of similar, not exactly the same, but similar. And what I have noticed, this hand is acrylic and there's a tutorial on this hand, and then this hand was gel. I kind of feel that the acrylic stain more, especially with me wearing like a black coat. You can see the edges of the acrylics being kind of stained more than the edges of the gel. I mean, that's what at least I think of. Like, I mean, the color is completely different, more stain on the acrylic hand than it is on the gel hand. And I think the reason for it is the acrylic, it can be soakable, like we can soak off the acrylic because it has those pores, while the gel you have to file off and it doesn't have those pores, which means the dirt doesn't absorb as quick as in the acrylics. So I think for this reason, I'm definitely preferring the gel even more. But anyway, I'm going to show you how to clip off the gems. I have loose on this finger, I have loose one big gem, and then I lost some gem in here as well. But they lasted me really, really well. So I've got the cuticle nipper and I'm going to clip them off. And when clipping off the crystals, you have to be kind of really careful to don't get them jump into your eyes or don't kill the cameraman, because he's just standing there. So I'm kind of really slowly trying to take them off. It's a shame, honestly, it is a big shame to take off those crystals. And would I reuse them? No, they've got lots of scratches, like, and they are not pretty. Maybe for some kind of designs on the tips, but in general, I'm thinking like once the crystals have been on for so long time, you really don't want to reuse them again. So when clipping off the crystals, you kind of have to find the easiest way to kind of clip them off, like the places where you can catch it on them. And doing it with my left hand, I mean, obviously, guys, I'm right-handed, so anything I'm doing on this tutorial is a really big struggle for me to do it with my left hand. Now, this big one, so close the eyes just in case. And the crystal is so strongly attached in that it is really difficult to take them off. The cameraman is moving away. Okay, once the big one is off, it is going to be much easier, because now I've got some room to catch the smaller crystals. Okay, so you can see it. I can take them off much easier now. And I'm really surprised like how the beads lasting as well, like those small caviar beads which have been around the crystals. But also when the crystal came off, you can see that there was a decent amount of the base like to hold everything in place, okay? So I'm still trimming them off. And as I say, it's like once we get rid of those big crystals, it becomes a bit easier to do that, because I've got some place where I can catch it. I'm going to have a big hoovering after all those clipping crystals. It was a full set, like, I mean, every single nail was with the crystals. And it's funny because I tried different cuticle nippers, like I had to try some large ones, like the ones for the toes, and I find it sometimes because they've got pretty big teeth, it's not always like a perfect solution, because sometimes they are too thick to catch the crystals. So they are pretty nice and good. Now the last caviar beads, because I don't want to damage my file on the caviar bead. I mean, obviously this is really damaging for a cuticle nippers, so you would use only like a kind of very old set of the cuticle nippers. So I'm just clipping them off, almost scraping off because they don't want to clip off. Okay, that's plenty, okay? So that's my nail freedom of all these crystals. They have been all pretty intact, like just because I have used the true Swarovski crystals on this set. And yeah, that's, you can see also the growth of my nail once I push back the cuticle, because that will be my next step. And I didn't want to remove the glitter completely for this pink Christmassy set, because I thought I want the sparkle to be visible from like underneath. I think it looks pretty cute, and then on the top nothing is going to be visible. So I'm just grabbing a file. Of course we could do it with the e-file, this part as well, but I'm just going to quickly file it. So I need to reshape this nail and get it nice and sharp again. I mean, obviously because I'm doing things with my left hand, it's going to be much more time consuming for me and much more difficult, okay? So I'm just filing those V-shape, and then I need to shorten those nails quite a lot. So nice and straight file, nice and straight file, and a pretty decent amount shorter. Like, I don't want them that long, because probably I'm not going to have a time for an infill next time if we get a Christmas rush. And guys, oh, I should show you before, you can see how extremely thick my nails are. So for all of you who think and say, oh, you have no apex, you're doing flat nails, oh, they are so slim, they are not going to last. Once I open them up, and that's, I wanted to also show you guys that's like this part for forever. They are so thick. But when they done, you can see how nice and thin they look, because I want my end to look like this. And then when I shorten them, they extremely, extremely thick, okay? And the more I will be shortening, the thicker they will become. I can show you even more, because that will go even thicker. Okay, so you can see it, I have shortened it and it become even more thick. Okay, so my structure go thin, then all the bulk, and then at the end it is nice and straight, but nice and thin. But I can only achieve it by doing a straight nail where the form is lifted up a little bit. Anyway, we need to remove all this bulk, like, because it's so huge, to make this nail nice and thin. So normally I would do this part with the e-file. I don't know why I hand file. Oh, maybe because I don't need to remove the full color of it. I want to keep the tiny bit of the sparkles. So I keep filing to remove this bulk. I also need to remove the base, which is on the top. And the longer moves of the files you do, the more product you are going to remove it. So that's another tip for someone who is a beginner nail tech. If you do kind of short movement of the file, you are just producing a heat, you are not filing a lot. If you do really long moves of the file, you are removing more product. Okay, I will just clean it from the dust, because I need to show you what I'm doing. So I have removed the bulk of the product. I still got a little bit excess at the free edge. And now I need to start blending those places where the base was and where the clistas, because I want to blend this product with my natural nail. Okay, I don't want to have any place where you can see where the product has started and where is my natural nails. This needs to be all blended nicely in. And for the reshaping, I'm using 100 grit. And then on my natural nails, I rather to use 180 grit, like I don't want to damage my natural nail. Clean it again. Okay, swap for 180 grit on my natural nail plate. Give those scratches to the natural nail plate. And I still need to blend this difference that is like kind of little bit of the loose product, might be a top coat or a base. Clean it, and I can still see it, so I would never keep something like this on my nails. All the chair and lamp is shaking when I'm doing this filing, but I'm almost there. So this is a wee lifting, and if I will be filing down the way, this is actually quite difficult to do it with the left hand, but if I will be filing too much down the way, the lifting is going to move and you never get rid of that. It will just keep moving. So I need to file it and cut it off. I kind of try to file it to the top rather than down the way. Okay, that was my really big problem when I started doing nails. Like, I didn't know how to file to get rid of the lifting because I was constantly moving this lifting down the way. Okay, I'm checking the thickness just a little bit more on those places. And that's it. That's my nail ready for maybe a touch more. And that's my nail ready for a fresh gel application. So I have removed the dust and I'm taking the blue scrub, which is a nail dehydrator, and I clean my nail really well, like really well. Okay, take this mess away. And then I'm going to use an extra nail dehydrator, and that's a nail prep on the entire nail, just a natural nail. And then universal air bond. So the universal air bond works like a double-sided tape, and I'm just applying it on top of the natural nail. Wait for it to dry, and then we can do the gel application, which is going to be pretty simple because that's a simple infill. So I'm going to use the soft pink fiber gel and my gel brush. First of all, pick up a small scoop of the product on the one side of the brush, and then pull the nail folds down, like I really want those nail folds down, and apply the product everywhere. So nice and thin layer everywhere. Cap those free edge. Nice and thin layer everywhere. Cap those free edge. And I'm working very close to the cuticle, like almost touching the cuticle. Extremely thin layer through the rest of the nail. Okay, and this will also work as my kind of base and give it a cure. So 30 seconds cure, and then we are going to apply the second layer and to move our apex and rebuild this nail. And I'm so excited, guys, because I will show you also a different mixture of the chromes. So I have been playing to create a beautiful pink chrome, and it is kind of like a nice pink color. We are also going to use amazing gems. I hope, like, I will see how we go with the set, but I think they are so beautiful. So that's a little stars, and they are from the Semilac. I got them in the stationery shop when we was in Poland, back in Szczecin. Actually, that was in one of the galleries, and they look so fantastic. I'm not sure if they've got their website in the UK, but you can search it in the internet. I think they're so cool. And the chromes, I will show you as well once I mix it. But let me build this nail first. and then we can move into a really exciting part. So I'm picking up another scoop of the product and doing exactly the same, okay? So those two thin layers give me a perfect thickness around the cuticle area and on the side of the nail. Those two thin layers. Okay, and then at the end, I'm pressing really hard with my brush. I don't want too much product in there. Picking up another scoop of the product, and now I need to check how the side view looks. So it's not too bad, but obviously I'm missing a product at the top because obviously when the nails grows, the apex is moving as well. So I'm just picking up the scoop of the product on my brush, and I'm going to fill up this gap. Hardly any pressure on the gel, and don't lift the brush from the product. Like once it hits the product, it stays with the product all the time, keeping the contact. Don't go too close to the sides, because by the time you finish it, the gel is going to run in there. So basically I have just filled up this gap. Okay, and once I have filled up this gap, I'm just going to take a brush and brush away the excess, the bulk of the product, to kind of blend that out. Okay, so that's the quickest way to do the rebalance, where we don't have to file later on as much, okay? Then cook it. So I'm just going to fully cure this nail, close my products and take them away. So put that away. Dust gel gives a little bit of the heat spike, so once it's cooked a little bit, I'm just going to peel it out for a couple seconds and then put it back in. And I think it will be nice to use some pink colors, like, and those beautiful stuff. And then the chromes, I'm going to show you. They are not top coated, but I was playing just before because I wanted to have the desired color of my chrome. So they're not top coated, they're not clean, and they kind of done on very old tips. But I was achieving a different colors just to make me happy, like to the desired shade I want on my nails. So I will also show you in this tutorial how to kind of achieve it and explain all the way. But let me file this nail first. We are not going to have much of the filing. So that's it cooked. I'm just removing the inhibition layer. Okay, so removing the inhibition layer. And now we are going to reshape this nail. So first of all, I needed this nail to go kind of slimmer and nice sharp coffin shape. So file the V-shape, and thumb is actually a torture to do it on yourself, like it is really hard. So V-shape. Okay, then start lifting this up. Like I want to remove the bulk of the product, which I've got on the sides. And now I show you how I filed. So you can see this part of the nail is filed, okay? And already this side look much slimmer. I have to do exactly the same on the other side. Very difficult task, like on your own. But you can see it again, the nails looks a little bit slimmer. We have to blend everything around the cuticle area. So blend that out. Okay, I will clean the nail for you. So we can see it, we have blended everything around the cuticle area. It is still kind of this rounded shape, and it is a little bit bulky at the end. So to get rid of those kind of rounded looking shape, I'm just going to go with the file all over in this motion. So starting from the sidewall, nice and straight, and keep filing like this. Okay, but I'm filing only this part of the nail, so I'm not touching the product like which is there. Okay, keep filing. All the way through the entire nail. Okay, and you can see it, how much nicer the nail look. Okay, much nicer. And same at the free edge, it's not as thick as it was before. I've got excess of the product in there, so I'm just touching there. And my next step is to take a buffer and just smooth this nail, and then we can move on into the exciting part, which is the decoration of all of those nails. So I'm just using a buffer, and it's a 100 grit buffer, and I have answered your question, guys, like regarding buffing the nails. So the gel is much easier to file, so the scratches are sufficient for the gel polish to stick into that. And also I'm using a buffer which is a 100 grit, so this is a pretty strong buffer. Like, it is not a smoothing buffer, it still creates lots of scratches. As you can see also, there are two air bubbles in here. That's because of my product control with my left hand. I'm pretty crap at it. Okay, so that's my nail getting to look nice. Couple more, and then clean them, and we can move on into the gel polish application and the chromes. So I can tidy up this mess. Okay, I can tidy up this mess. I'm just checking the around the cuticle area. Okay, one more touch. You really don't want any bits and pieces there. Okay, and I show you the difference. You can see it. I have brushed away this mess around the cuticle area, so I can get really close with my gel polish. Perfect. To get rid of those air bubbles, if we would do the baby boomer, it would be a problem. You would have to apply the top coat and cover those bubbles. If this is just a gel polish will stuck in there, and that wouldn't be a problem. But let's move on into the chrome application. So I just wipe all this mess in here. So we've got nice and clean nails, and we will do some mixture. So exciting part, I show you when I open it. Okay, so that's my mix, and you can see it is a nice kind of like a pale pink, and I made it out of those two colors. Okay, so I use this one, and you can see that there is a tiny bit of the silver one because I didn't clean my cuticle pusher. So I'm just going to show you how I do it on the lid. So you would take a drop of the silver one, okay, and then the drop of the pink one. Mix it well to create the desired color. Obviously, when we shake it in a pot, like when we close the pot, then the mixture is even better. But that should be plenty to show you the results. And I've got some old tips. Like, I've got full pack of the old tips, and they are awesome. Cameraman, you don't need to show that. This is ugly back.
Too late.
Okay, so I can show you how this mixture of the chrome would look on this nail. Okay, so on this nail, they really old tips, so it wouldn't cover it well, but it's just to show you. So on the orangey color, we will get something like this. Then if I would use something nude, on nude, I should get a really nice kind of light pink. I can show you absolutely amazing color. Okay, so this is a really, really nice color. And basically, by changing the base color and by adding more silver or more pink, you can really create the color you want to achieve. Okay, I might also show you maybe how it will look on the red. It's actually on gray. I'm surprised how nice it looks on the gray. And maybe I will, yeah, show you on the gray as well. So it looks really beautiful on the gray too. Okay, so that's the colors which we can achieve on the gray. But anyway, so that was the fun creating, like, and you can see it, like, different bases gives us different results. So that's the three which we have created now, plus I have created quite a few different ones, trying on the different colors, just so I could achieve the desired mixture. So with only two colors of the chrome, you can create, wow, so much. So let me close them. And because I'm quite happy with the color, I can use the clear base. So what I'm going to do it now, I'm going to clean my nails and we can start with the chrome application and some sugaring. So I'm just cleaning my hand, cleaning the mess. And on the pink, I'm just using a blue scrub to really properly clean my nails. And on the pinky, we are going to match a glitter as well. So I've got two different types of the glitter. And this one is too strong color for me. So I need to mix it with a different one so we can do a nice and beautiful sugar. And I think we'll do sugar on the thumbnail as well. So what we are going to do is, oh my goodness, I should have a clear pot. Okay, I'm going to use this pot. I was thinking I might maybe use the silver foil as well. Like, I've got always so many different ideas. So I'm going to have this pink. And then I'm going to have this color as well, just to lighten up this pink. And again, it is still too dark. I might put a drop of this one. All these mixtures. I feel like an, I don't know, a witch in the laboratory preparing a mixtures. Okay, this is a better color. It's much lighter. Much lighter. Awesome. So I'm just going to close the pots. And on those two nails, we are going to achieve this sugar. So I'm going to use the High Shine No Wipe Top Gel to create the sugar look. And all what I have to do is, on the set which we have created, I mean, you could do it a clear set, like, I mean, just an nudie-ish pink color, or you could paint them pink as well. I'm just going to use it on the clear. And I'm going to do the same on my thumbnail. So I need to cover the entire nail. Pretty decent amount right in the middle. And then the glitter which we have created, I'm going to sprinkle my nails. So I'm just sprinkle my nails with the glitter. Oh my goodness, it is so beautiful. I will show you guys in a minute. I hope the camera can catch it. If not, yeah, good. I'm always so worried when I'm sometimes doing some things and they may be not visible in the camera. So tap the excess and look how pretty it is. Wow. Okay, doing the same on the thumbnail. No, you can't see it. Okay. Is it better?
No.
Okay. Okay, I'm trying my best, guys. Oh my goodness, we have created such a beautiful mixture of the glitter. Okay, I need to cover the sides, so my nail goes to the side. Sorry, I'm putting myself in an awkward position because I want you guys to see it. And I really want to sprinkle the entire nail, like, I don't want any missing gaps. Okay, anyway, you have seen it, so I'm just going to do my job quickly. Remove the excess of it, and you can see how nice and beautiful this nail as well. And so does this one. I'm going to cook them, but I don't need to cook it fully, so I will just give the free skewer, and then we can move on into the next step. Oh my goodness, this glitter is so beautiful. And I'm so big waste girl. I should put some piece of paper, or like I've got the triangles, but I didn't. So I'm just going to quickly wipe this away. Okay, freezing my product in the lamp. And the next step is to use some color, and I've got two colors and I'm not sure which one should I pick up. So I've got 155, which is my favorite kind of nudie pinkish, and I've got 158, which is rose. I don't know how to pronounce it. Okay, so I need to check what color I want. Okay, and I've got two colors, lighter or darker, cameraman?
Lighter.
He says lighter. Actually, light. Oh gosh. Now I'm going to take 3 days to pick up the color. No, lighter. Darker?
Darker this time.
Okay. For a change. Yeah, I know, because I always use this one. I always use this color, like, it's always. So this color is going to go into the index finger. Yeah, that darker color is a good choice, because then we can do some white design on top of it. Okay, I'm just really taking my time, because obviously I'm rubbish at painting with the left hand. And then pushing the product to the cuticle. Okay, these two fingers are going to be our chrome, the one which we have just mixed. So again, I'm applying the high shine no wipe top gel. And this task, it is kind of easy. Come on guys, it's just to apply the top coat, but it's crucial to get it perfect if you want to have a nice chrome results. If we don't apply it perfect, it is going to show in the chrome. So same, any kind of imperfection of the nails, the chrome is going to show it as well. Very, very tricky and difficult to apply the chrome. Now, if you want to know how to create the base nail, which I've got underneath, like before we have done the refill, there is the tutorial on those nails as well. Like, they had lots of crystals on and those kind of milky, bluish, glittery ombre at the free edge. So check this tutorial too. Okay, what I'm doing is I'm checking how the light is reflecting in the top coat. Any kind of dust, any kind of scratch with the top coat, like almost when you even press too hard with your brush, is going to really show it, and I don't want that. So once I'm happy, I'm going to cook it in a lamp. The gel polish cures in 30 seconds, and then the top coat for a chrome should cure 60 seconds. So this is going to be a perfect timing, because we can cure the gel polish in 30 seconds, apply the second layer, and then cure the top coat for our chrome application. Okay, so I'm just going to move the chrome, because we are going to need it. And I will show you maybe how to do the snowflake as well out of the glitter. Gosh, I want to show you so many different things. Like, I wish to put everything on my nails for this Christmas set. And what I noticed as well, like, I mean, this year, and it started even last year, people don't necessarily go for a red Christmas nails. Like, I mean, a couple years ago, everyone was having like Christmas green nails, glittery nails. And from last year, I noticed like anything is allowed on the Christmas. So if you're fan of the pink nails, you would get a pink Christmas nail. If you're fan of the purple nails, you will have a nice purple set with some snowflakes or like a Christmassy design. And there is nothing absolutely wrong. Oh my goodness, look at this color. Like, it's so beautiful. It is really beautiful. Anyway, stick it into the lamp. And then my chrome, I need to put it, because my nails are so long, I need to put it to the lid so I'm able to apply it on my nails. So I'm just curing a 30 seconds. And we're definitely going, I think, to use the snowflakes. I will see how they go with the color. And then if I'm not happy, I can show you guys, because I've got another snowflakes. And we could create a really beautiful snowflakes out of those shapes. So this is so cool as well. Cameraman, I need you. Perfect, thank you. So this is a really nice shapes too. And I'm going to take a couple of them out. And we can create a really beautiful snowflakes out of it as well. And I think that's kind of goes with the pink set we have created. So what I would do is put them into the flower shape. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like, and we get a nice snowflake. Okay, top coat going on this one. Does it, or I want the gems? Gosh, what I want on this one? What I want? I don't know. Oh my goodness, I don't know what I want. Anyway, no, do the crown first and then we can decide what we want to do next. So I'm just dipping in my finger. I'm so undecided, like, and I'm start. Oh my goodness, look at this. Wow. Oh my goodness, this is so beautiful. So beautiful pink chrome nails. Okay, I'm rubbing this chrome in really properly. And then clean the excess. Like, if you want the chrome to be really nice and chromy, you need to clean all those bits and pieces. Like, you don't want those things on your nails. I'm just cleaning it really properly. And then take a nail file. So put all your glitters and the pots on the side. Take a nail file and create a couple scratches. If you don't do the scratches, oh, there we are. You can see also I've got some wee bits and pieces of the dust. So in the chrome, it's always showing off. So take your time. Like, I mean, even if it will take you double time, it is definitely worth it to get a perfect chrome finish. So remove the excess of the pigment. And now we are going to apply this top coat over them. And make sure you cap the free edge, like you really want to cap the free edge. And the top coat on the next nail. Now I know that I want some design on my ring finger, and this is going to be a similar design to my index finger, just so they are matching together. I'm going to cure the nails. Okay, my hand is almost cooked, so we are going to take the soak of base gel. Oh, I'm getting good at it. Soak of base gel and my mixing palette. tiny bit of it on my mixing palette and some old kind of brush. Perfect. So I didn't apply any top coat, of course, on this one yet, just because I want to save myself a hassle, because if we're going to stick in some gems, then it will be good to don't have this top coat yet. And what I'm going to do is I want this gold snowflake. Okay, so I'm applying a very decent amount of the base. Yeah. See,
never prepare,
he says. Oh my goodness, we need to see one day how he does the nails, sir. Thanks.
Don't wanna.
You don't wanna?
You, not me.
Okay, and then I'm going to stick in this huge, beautiful snowflake. Oh my goodness, I love the snowflake. I do love the snowflake. It's amazing. Okay, because it's such a large crystal, we need to place it nice and straight, and with straight hand, we need to freeze it inside the lamp. Okay. If you wouldn't do it, it might move. And I don't want that to move. Like, I really don't want that to move. Stay there. Behave. And we also want to do some sugar wintery design. So I need paint on French gel. Cameraman, I've got too many brushes. There we are. That's the one I was searching for. Sorry, guys, it is really late. Like, I mean, it is evening, like very late evening the now. So we are tired now. Okay. Yes, this is so cool. Okay, I love this snowflake. And then I want the snowflake to go onto the chromey nail as well, because I want those two nails to match. But because we have to apply the top coat on the chrome, we need to buff this top coat now if we want the crystals to stay on. So I'm taking a buffer. This is actually good. I will get rid of those wee places which I didn't like. So you've got the buffer and you're gently buffing the chrome. Like, you don't want to overdo it. If you overdo it, you will overfile your chrome. Just a little scratches. Okay, clean it well. Gosh, I love this kind of mixture on the nails, like a little bit of everything in there. So we've got the chrome and we need to apply the beautiful snowflake as well on this nail. So I'm taking the base again, huge amount of it. I have also recorded, guys, tutorial for you how to make snowflakes out of the gems as well. It might be either already posted or it is going to be posted very soon. Okay, so a bit higher. They're really not easy to stick on just because they're large. Like, they're really large crystals. Cool. Cook it a couple seconds, and just before I go with it over with the top coat, I'm going to pick up the base, and I suggest you do that because these crystals, we normally, I would build up my crystal structure like on this nail, where you've got very large crystal which is surrounded by a smaller ones, and this way you've got a nice even transition, so the crystals are not catchy. In this case, because it is a single crystal, what I need to do is I need to pick up a base and I need to go around it. Like, in the places where the crystals might be catchy, I want to lift those places, like show you maybe the side view. Can you see it? Like, here I've got an empty space. So what I'm taking is a tiny bit of the base and I'm filling up the space with the tiny bit of the base. Okay, just so it is not going to be catchy. Like, I don't want the crystals to catch on my hairs or, you know, rip my tights or anything like that. So extra base, and same on this one, you can see this part is raised. So a base going in there, like almost even underneath. Like we want these crystals to last me a long, long time. Especially that they're so beautiful, like I don't want them to come off. Okay, awesome. Cook it. So again, just a couple seconds to freeze it. And then we are going to apply the High Shine No Wipe Top Gel again. So also when we're building up the design in so many different layers, it's worth to don't make them too thick, because with extra layer of the top coat, extra layer of the color, they are just becoming thicker and thicker. Okay, so now once I've got all my crystals placed in here, I'm going with the top coat around the crystal. So the top coat on the entire nail back in again. That's why we had to file the chrome top coat, so it did the next layer of the top coat is going to stick it to that. Sorry so much for taking like so long, but obviously this is my struggling hand, so it's pretty difficult. Okay, and with this top coat, I'm really kind of pushing it around the crystal as well. Freeze this one. So 2 seconds, clean your brush and do the same on this nail. Okay, so those two nails are going to be exactly the same with some snow and a snowflake. I don't know yet what I want to do on the middle finger. Something maybe with the sugar to connect the thumb. Yeah, that's a good idea. So something with the sugar to connect my pinky and a thumb nail with the entire design, and also to get this color through it as well. Okay, so the top coat is really going strongly around the crystal, like almost covering the edges of it. And then once you're happy, give it a cure. And because we have to cure the ring finger and the index finger with the stars pretty a long time, I'm going to start doing the design on the middle finger. So paint on French gel or sugar. Oh my goodness, what I want to do. Paint on French gel with the glitter which we have used to have some sugar design. Yes, that's what we are going to do it. So very difficult task, painting with my left hand, but hey ho, I do everything for you guys. Cool, and now we are going to do those sugar design on this nail. So for sugar, I'm going to use this time paint on French. You could do it with the top coat as well, like the same way like we did it. But with the top coat, it could be kind of difficult to show you how to paint this design. So all what I want to do is do a kind of wave or something. Okay, so I have done some wave. And I wanted it to be nice and clean at the edges. Again, this is a task which is really easy to do it with the right hand, very difficult to do it with the left hand. And I want to have a pretty nice nail, so sorry guys, I'm going to take ages. Okay, last touches up just to make it nice and neat. Okay, and I'm happy-ish with it. So I'm going to do Because it's a Christmassy design, I'm going to do another one. Huge concentration. Also, let me know down in the comments below what colors are your Christmas inials. Like, I want to know, is anyone else having a pink Christmas set? I actually like that so much. Maybe one more? Yes or no? No.
No,
that will be too much. Yes. Too much is not good. Okay, I like those two lines. And I'm going to sprinkle them with the sugar. And if needed, I might add a tiny bit of something white in there, because I also like how the white looks on it. Gosh, please don't make a mess out of it. I hope it will look good. Sometimes it is hard to decide like what we want to go for and if it's going to look good or is going to break the look we wanted. Okay, so I have sprinkled it with the glitter. And now I'm going to cook it, just so I've got some sugary design as well. Oh my goodness, this is also... I think we should also go for something around the cuticle area on the other crystal ones. So just to save the time, I'm going to do a quick design in here. Gosh, I don't want to overdo it because they're kind of really pretty. And the tiny one. Okay, that's plenty. Exactly the same on this one. And we are almost finished this wintry set. I have touched the cuticle. And paint on French gel is absolutely fantastic, like for a sugaring, because you can see it what you're doing really better than painting with the top coat. But of course, you could use the top coat as well for a sugar design or any other gel which has like a little inhibition layer. Now let me clean the mess I have done. I should actually get myself a left-handed cuticle pusher. Did you guys know it? There is a thing which... A thing like this which exists, a left-handed cuticle pusher, because it does the job much better. Gosh. Come on, I don't want to have ugly cuticles. Okay, clean that. Cameraman is laughing probably now. No, he's not laughing. He's supportive. He's supporting with me doing a left And that's it. But guys, I think I still need lots of practice when it comes to my left hand, like lots of practice, but I feel it is anyway a little bit better. Like my hand doesn't shake as much as it used to be when I started doing my right hand with the left hand. Okay, cool. So I quite like the white parts, and I think I'm going to add even white parts on the middle finger. So what I'm going to do is take another sugar effect, this time the indigo one, and we are going to sprinkle it. This is going to be so Christmassy set. Okay, so we have sprinkled this part, cook it in, and then we are going to do just something white in the middle finger to kind of match all the entire design. And then I can show you the final look of them. So I need to cure it about 30 seconds and then take a brush and remove the excess glitter from the middle finger. Okay, so or maybe I don't need to add something. No, I'm just going to keep it like this. Or maybe I will. Okay, something very difficult now. I did it. Okay, so just tidy up this line. I can't. Oh. Okay, guys, don't tidy up the lines. That's it. I'm not going to touch it anymore in case I break it, because I quite like it the way it is. So I'm going to cook it. And now I've got everything which connects the set. So even we have created slightly different shades, slightly different colors, everything joins in into one set, which is kind of matching, because we have added some white on the three fingers. We've got the sugar, which is connecting the pinky and the other ones, so I'm pretty chuffed for that. And I've got a few new mixtures of the glitters as well, so I hope you have really enjoyed it, like the tips and tricks regarding the mixtures of the chromes. And there is also another set of the beautiful nails I have done. I really like them too, where I have mixed my own gold chrome. I might even have it here. So yes, I have this one as well. So that's my own mixture of the chrome as well, by adding. So here we have created one by adding those two, and the other one, the goldy one, I have created by mixing the silver one with the gold to get a kind of really nice pale gold effect, and I think it's absolutely a fantastic color. So let's move all this on the side, and now I can finally show you the results which we have created today. And I need to think something different on this hand as well, because this hand is desperated for a rebalance, and I thought maybe something more difficult, like I could paint like a wee reindeer, or like, I don't know, a Santa, like a real one, or I don't know. I will think something special, guys, for you, just to say thank you for supporting this channel, for all the likes and shares. So you can hit the share button for this set as well, if you really enjoy it, watching it, and you have learned something new. Now for the sugar effect, I always tend to finish it off with the file. So I will take a file and I will just do a couple scratches of the file to remove any rough surface, so it's not catchy. Actually, I could have all set like, I really like this middle finger. It's so nice and pretty. And then I would take a wipe and just like clean my cuticles and apply the cuticle oil to show you the final look. I'm going to do a definitely beautiful thumbnail picture just so you can see it. But this middle finger is so beautiful. Let me know down in the comments below also which finger is your favorite one. Cameraman is showing the middle one is favorite for him as well. And I think actually the same. I love the middle finger. The most is so Christmassy feel to it, and yeah, glittery hugs. I hope I pronounced it wrong. No, correct. Anyway, it doesn't matter which way I pronounce. You know, guys, what I mean. So I'm sending you lots of loves and cuddles instead of the hugs this time. Bye for now.